Okay, morning guys. Today we are doing a test on the crankshaft position sensor on this Kawasaki ER6. Okay, Duncan, get the fans on that thing. We're using a oscilloscope made by Pico. In this case, we're just using channel A. And the software, just now you can see we have 0 volts. This scale is going from 0 to 50. In this case, we've got 0 volts, and the time scale on the bottom is 20 millisecond divisions. So just now, without the engine cranking, you can see that there's 0 voltage being generated by the crank sensor. We've got some pins in the sensor, so we're back probing that. All right, Duncan, just when you're ready, you can fire that up. Okay, so now you can see we have high peaks about 10 volts. That's alternating current, plus or minus 10. And we can have, if I pause the software, that's fine, doesn't it? If I pause the software, you can see the higher peak, the longer and higher peak, it's indicating the particular crankshaft position on the top dead centre. So now we'll give it a wee rev. On you go, Duncan. You can switch it off, thanks. Thank you. So now, with the engine going a bit faster, you can see the peaks are much closer together. They're higher, they're up about 15 or 20 volts instead of 10, which they were at idle. And the peaks up here about 25 volts. And there's a lot more signals being shown in the same amount of time. In this case, it's 200 milliseconds total, 0.2 of a second. So it shows you how fast the crankshaft is actually going, and everything that's happening in one engine cycle of the crankshaft position sensor. So in this case, that sensor looks absolutely fine, which is great. Okay, see you next time.